Well, a very good evening to you on what is pretty close to an ideal evening for football. There is barely a cloud evident. The world and his wife have gone to great lengths to be here for a match of great consequence and massive interest in these parts. Barely a breath of wind, so the football has no excuses for not being at its very best. The teams I know are pumped for this. There are fantastic scenes in the stands. There is a great sense of drama here, a great sense of excitement and expectation. We survey Milan's famous Curva Sud, one of the truly great shrines of the beautiful game. This is the perfect game for all parties, not least the neutrals who've just come to enjoy it.
Yes, Peter, it's a shame it's only a friendly, but then again, that may help us see a more expressive attacking contest. And I'd be prepared to settle for a clash of lesser intensity in favour of lots of flair, skill and plenty of tricks and a few goals. I suspect I've probably overstretched my level of greed here.
So away we go then. How do you think this turns on, Jim?
Yeah, Virgil van Dijk. He's just about unbeatable in every department, Peter. He's strong, he's quick, he's totally dominant in the air. And what's more, he seems to really love a tussle. His passing's good too, and he never seems to lose it in important areas. I'd expect this team to notch up a lot of clean sheets with him on board.
Must agree, especially in view of his ability to lead and organise the defence. A reprieve, albeit perhaps momentary. Alaba. Marco Verratti. He's had a goal! Gorgeous control there. Gundogan. And the finish! Oh, great save, real class.
Gundogan sparked a tremendous stop there, and I think it's fair to add, he just wasn't expecting it.
Steered in. Goretzka knocks it away. And he's got the ball glued to his feet. Loose ball, who's going to get there?
And it's Gundogan.
Out to the left it goes. Alaba, played into the middle, has a pop, it's broken loose.
That's a cracking strike and it may have stung the palms of the keeper.
Jorginho, Icardi gets into a dangerous position.
Galatasaray made it clear what they're trying to do for me, Peter. Well, I think they're making the pitch as big as possible to work both flanks into better supply routes.
Lewandowski outside.
Galatasaray
retain the ball, but are seemingly in no rush to break forward. Foot in. Jorginho did well to step in there. That was more than necessary. Trippier. Forward it goes. João Cancelo. João Cancelo drives it forward. Back to the keeper and tries something new. Donnarumma gets it upfield. Has gone out. Oh, that's neat. Van Dijk positions himself well and cuts it out. Now it's Lewandowski. Lewandowski gets it out to the wing. João Cancelo goes for the cross.
Well, when the options aren't quite present in the box, it's the crosser's interest to hold on for the support.
Jimenez to play it forward. He gets past his man. So who's he picking out? And that's out of reach. Throws it out to the flank. Well, that's where he wants it. Ronaldo gets it back. And here's Lewandowski. Hoists it forward. And it's Coutinho. And here's Mauro Icardi. Out to the right. Messi gets it into the middle. Oh, well intercepted. Really alert to the danger. And it's half-time here. So another team has broken through. But certainly not for the want of trying. It's been an interesting game up to now. But still goals. Any opinion you'd like to express on the first half?
Well, they look lost for ideas and lacking in talent, which all contributes to a chronic case of impotence.
An engrossing half, but we're still where we started, 0-0. things going for the second half.
Milan pretty fortunate not to be trailing at half-time. They've been lacklustre and second best for me. If ever a situation demanded a telling off from the boss, it's this one. It has to spark a reaction.
Trippier. Nainggolan. Trippier. Nainggolan. Goretzka. Coutinho.
Philippe Coutinho!
Good first touch and almost as good a second.
Philippe Coutinho brilliantly took control of that, which was exactly what the situation required.
Jorginho. Here's Mauro Icardi.
And Messi!
Stop. It wasn't easy.
Well, that was high-class goalkeeping there to back up his high-class weight.
In it comes. And it's Gundogan. He's making good use of his strength there, just refuses to be out-muscled. Time for a change in personnel. Another corner. Any better luck this time round? Cleared away. And the defence can get it clear. Icardi. Good challenge, he just stood firm. Well, the defence got the better of him this time, but I'm sure he'll go again. Nainggolan. Well, nil the score, and we're just about done. A deeply frustrating game. Looking for a decent ball in. It's Nainggolan.
And the shot!
A collective sigh of relief from the defence. João Cancelo. Marco Verratti. Gundogan. João Cancelo. Ball's loose, who's getting there? Mbappe battles to win it back. And it's Verratti. A nice touch. Aimed in towards the centre.
Tries a header!
Just couldn't turn it in.
I have to commend the wing play, but I have to condemn the defending. They've got to stop the cross.
Gundogan cuts it out. Lewandowski. That's a foul, no two ways about it. No second thought, a straight red card. Well, there may be some scope for debate over the seriousness of the offence, but none over its repercussions. To see out the rest of the game with 10 men.
Galatasaray showing a good level of intensity at this stage. They're calling on all their resources now. Galatasaray clearly seem to have lost their passing accuracy, something they're obviously going to have to fix pretty quickly now.
Played out to the right. Mbappe looks to get on the end of this. And it's Cancelo. Gundogan. Marco Verratti. João Cancelo.
Mbappe pumps it into the area.
Tries to get it clear.
When you're struggling for numbers, you try to create that defensive compactness and conserve energy, but fatigue begins to play a much bigger role, and it may well yet make all the difference here. Galatasaray merit full marks for their attitude and application in trying to win this. It means an awful lot, obviously.
Goretzka. Jorginho. Philippe Coutinho.
He'll hit it!
The assistant referee rightly gives him offside.
Well, both sides might have to settle for a draw here, although there's still a chance for one last fling. Well, he's worked so hard for his side, as you would expect, but couldn't help notice that he was starting to labour a bit, so it's no surprise.
Now it's Messi.
He spotted the run and played him through. You wonder if that's it now, but there may be one more opportunity, Peter, for a late steal here.
Tries to dink it in. And out to safety. The 90 minutes are up, 30 more to come.
Well, 0-0 doesn't offer a fair reflection of what we've seen. The game's been vibrant. I think the atmosphere has remained buoyant, and we just need the scoreline to step into line.
So a brief breather, and then extra time.